Hi everybody, David Dilling from Markzware. Today's how-to, how to get files ready for Prepress. Today's how-to is rather generic. It can apply to working in QuarkXPress or Adobe InDesign or even for that matter Microsoft Word or Microsoft Publisher. How to get files ready for Prepress, on one hand rather straightforward, on the other hand can be complicated. It's important to understand your desired output and the checklist of things to do and, most importantly, not to do when creating this file. Here in InDesign CS5, when you make a new file, which is very similar in QuarkXPress and Microsoft Publisher and CorelDRAW, when you create a new document, you get asked several questions. In this case, you can make a file for web or for print. It's important to choose print if you're going to print this document. There's ways to switch a web file into a print file, but it's much easier to start off right away with the default print settings, which will come back later when we export this file for use in Prepress. We have done that with this little sample file here, and I can go ahead and place objects in there under File, Place, and I can add all kinds of images, native Illustrator files, .psd Photoshop images, pretty much you name it, JPEGs. But once again, yeah, we just can't throw everything we want at the printer. It has to be printable. What you see on the screen will print much differently after it's processed through a rip and plates are made and output on the printing press or even printed digitally. There's this great site I found, which although in the educational side of things, it has a great list of troubleshooting files for print. And it starts off with general print trouble solutions, and then it goes over per file type, whether it's Adobe Illustrator, Adobe InDesign, and you see a whole bunch there, or Photoshop, plotting, and the potential errors that can occur. It's a relatively recent file, and I'll put a link to it in the movie. So you see there's many areas in which you can look out for when you're creating a file. And that's where Markzware FlightCheck comes in. Because no matter what you prepare, you need to ensure that it's going to output or print properly. And that's exactly what FlightCheck will do. It'll check not only the resulting PDF file, but also the native files, the InDesign file, the QuarkXPress file, the Adobe Illustrator file, the Photoshop file, to make sure that it doesn't have one of the hundreds of potential errors that FlightCheck can help stop. We'll come back to FlightCheck in a moment. The process to FlightCheck, or the process of preflighting, can be done with the eyeball method as well. However, as your document grows, the more tedious, time-consuming, and likely that you won't find the problems anyway with your eyeball it is. And we'll show you how FlightCheck works in a moment. It's very important to ensure that you use high-res imagery, anywhere between 205 and 305 or higher DPI or effective resolution. But you don't want to use a too high resolution file if you're outputting a general newsletter, for that'll just slow down the rip. You want to make sure you're using the proper color models for the output device desired. You want to ensure that you don't use hairlines or you don't use fonts that won't be embeddable. So if you're getting this file from a friend or another graphic designer, you want to ensure you have the same fonts. These and many more are many of the tips you need to remember when you're creating your file and what you should check for with FlightCheck before you output your file. Best way to get files ready for Prepress is to send to the Prepress department, the printer, a print-ready PDF. You do that via file export in Adobe InDesign. Same applies in Adobe Illustrator, QuarkXPress, etc. You choose here the format, Adobe PDF Print. Once again, don't just choose Adobe PDF Interactive. Choose the print, the high resolution. And what you'll see when we save this down, we'll get a set of options. And these options are very important. You can choose one of the many standards available. And you want to ask or check with your Prepress department which standard they prefer, if any. In InDesign itself, it comes preset with a high-quality print. And you can choose the compatibility of which version of Acrobat it will work with. gives you more information and a lot of different things you can check or uncheck. You know, the list goes on, really, and that's why it's important to check with your printer, with your prepress department, on exactly what standard they want to use. Many will use PDFX4, PDFX1A, it's still even in use. And when you choose that and you click export, you'll then get a print-ready PDF. Or wait, or will you? Well, that's where the process of preflight comes in, and now let's show you how that works in FlightCheck. In FlightCheck, the heart of FlightCheck is the ground controls. This is really something you can set up yourself by using the default settings or one of the many presets, but also something your prepress department can help you set up and share with you. You'll notice the checks are pretty much what we just discussed. You can check for resolution to catch any low res images that might pass in. You can check for mode, for instance, no RGB color images. Any different settings for your fonts, where you can check for missing or inactive fonts, non-embedded fonts, etc., etc. We'll take one of our many test files here and just drop it onto the FlightCheck flight strip. The preflight initiates, and you'll see FlightCheck gathers all relative details and information on this file. Everything linked or used is reported on. Printer, colors, trapping, fonts, images, you name it. The FlightCheck Eagle comes back and lets us know it found some problems. Red are problems, blue are warnings. We can tab through and quickly see information. But of course our main areas are our colors, fonts, and images, and that's what we have opened here now. So FlightCheck is a way to very quickly find and stop problems before you export to the PDF, which we just showed you. There's also ways to help you through, for instance, the page layout, to go through the page or the file page by page. So you can quickly see, elements used outside the page. Let's launch that document and go fix it. Or in the case if you have the file open, you just cruise back over and you fix the file. It's a different file in this case, but you see how it would work. Finally, in FlightCheck, there is a collect feature or package, which is very important for Illustrator and Photoshop users to package and collect their work in those files, but it can also package and preflight, of course, InDesign, Quark files as well, and many other file formats. It'll gather all fonts and images into one folder, even compressing the job for sending to the printer, perhaps, or to other parties. To get your files ready for prepress may mean sending the entire native or open file. So you might need to send this entire InDesign file with used fonts, used images to the next party to work further on it, or to your colleague across the hall. This way they know for sure they have all the elements and they can get everything on their system independently working very quickly. Another great feature of FlightCheck, the package or collect job. That way when you're back into the InDesign file in this case and you do the file export to PDF, you'll know for sure this file will now be 100% print ready. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Preflight first with FlightCheck, then export to PDF. That's how to get files ready for prepress, the professional way. Oh, by the way, here we are back in the ground controls in FlightCheck. We can also check the resulting PDF of FlightCheck, which is standalone, doesn't need to have Acrobat or InDesign on this machine. So it's a great tool for anybody to use in graphic arts, whether you're in the administration side, the selling side, the receiving side, even the prepress side, but definitely as a graphic designer side, you should use this to check your files both before you make the PDF and after. But watch this. The ground controls in FlightCheck will switch automatically to the PDF ground controls. So FlightCheck is smart enough to see that it's a PDF file and switches the checks to be 100% PDF relevant. The printer might be able to fix many of these, but it's best to take matters into your own hand. For instance, printer can't make a low-res image high resolution. You need to correct that yourself. Place the proper high-res file in the native InDesign file before you export the PDF. There's a host of other tips. Of course, I've oversimplified this process, but in general, if you use tools like FlightCheck to act as a checklist, communicate with the prepress department or printer to know what to check for or what to have on your checklist, creating a print-ready file is not all that difficult. So when you do a file export, you'll know for sure that that file is going to be 100% ready for printing. For more information on FlightCheck, just go over to www.markzware.com/products/FlightCheck, and you can even download the free 30-day trial version yourself. Under the article section, there's a great article on how to create a clean PDF with Markzware FlightCheck. Here you read about Wild Pete Publishing and how they use FlightCheck pretty much religiously to check all files before generating PDFs for their catalogs. Really a great article on why FlightCheck and how important it is. I'll put a link to this down below in the more information section as well. Thank you. This is David Dilling from Markzware on how to get files ready for prepress. Peace.